good to see you all here in New York and also online. I was just checking the chat. Somebody's already doing a AI count. I think we're at 18. So for the montage, AI. There, we can add it in later. I'm not going to talk too much about AI here. We'll save that for Jared. I'm going to talk about our infrastructure. We all love fast sites, both developers trying to build something that loads really quickly and customers who are trying to build that really snappy product experience. And on Vercel, we give all developers, even y'all in the free tier, the fastest possible experience out of the box. But everything's fast at Hello World, right? We want to help you stay fast over time as your site grows and as you become more successful. So let's talk about some of the improvements we've been making to our function startup times, as well as our global infrastructure to make this possible. And let's start with cold starts. While cold starts aren't really a problem for really large sites, they can be painful for smaller applications. So let's dig in and let's see how often this happens on the Vercel platform. So Vercel serves about 100 billion requests per week. Decent amount. And a subset of these functions power your Next.js applications, your APIs for your Svelte pages, or your dynamic e-commerce stores built with Nuxt. Now, of that subset, about 0.5 of those function invocations are cold starts. Now, I know what you're thinking. Lee, that's BS. I've felt that. I've had a site that started up slowly. It was painful. And they do exist, especially for customers who have lower traffic sites. Now, while most functions are already warm, we want to help make this fast even when you have a function that starts up slow. And that's the difference between a good or great experience of your product. So, what are we doing about it? Well, what we're going to talk about today are three different categories. But first, I want to toss out this poll to you all. So if you could use this QR code or go to ship-vote.vercel.app here in New York or online, I'm curious to hear what you all think is the main reason for a cold start. We're going to have a couple options here for you to check out. Is it Vercel's infrastructure? Is it the framework runtime? Is it user code? Or my favorite, is it a skill issue? If you're talking about me, it probably is a skill issue, so I can see why that one might get more votes than others. So we'll let the votes tally in here a little bit. Got people online, people here. That's a pretty close race. Let's see, skill issues are gonna win out? Maybe. Okay, framework runtime takes the lead, the fastest horse in the race. Okay, we'll call it for here. We've been digging in further on all of these options, and we want to talk about how we can improve this startup time across the infra, across the framework code, as well as user code. So all three of these make up a cold start, even though sometimes it's a skill issue for me as well, too. So let's start with our infrastructure. Vercel functions now get proactively initialized. You can think about this kind of like how prefetching works in Next.js. So as a request to a function comes in, we're able to automatically start up that function ahead of time with no manual work required. You don't need to go in and tweak any knobs. It just keeps it fast. Now, let's say you do have a cold start, which does happen. How can we make that as fast as possible? Well, of course, as the kids are doing, we have to rewrite it in Rust. That's the solution, rewrite in Rust. Now, I know it's kind of a meme, but it actually has been extremely impactful for us. So we recently announced our Rust-powered Vercel functions, and we've seen 80 millisecond faster cold starts on average, and 500 milliseconds faster cold starts in the largest applications. And this is data coming from real Vercel customer traffic as well, too. So that's our infra. For the framework in Next.js, we've been working hard over the last year to minimize the framework runtime size when it gets bundled into a Vercel function. And also, we've tried to remove as many unused dependencies as possible, because a smaller runtime means a faster startup time. So that's some framework changes. But let's get to the good stuff. Let's get to what we're doing for your code. So most of this cold start comes from the code that's provided into the function. And we think there's an opportunity here. What can we do here? Ideally, there was a way that we could just optimize this user code for you. Well, today, we're excited to announce bytecode-optimized Vercel functions, which we've been validating with select customers. We've seen up to 30% faster cold starts for larger applications from these bytecode optimized functions. And this is huge because most of that cold start time is from the heaviest object in the world, my node modules folder. It animated off the screen, there's so much. So let's talk a little bit about how this works, how this bytecode optimization works. So a visitor comes into our site and invokes a function, and then the code, my source code, gets read and compiled down into that bytecode. Can you believe that? At runtime, it's parsing and compiling all of that code before just ultimately ending up in this, that's real bytecode. I mean, if it all ends up as bytecode, couldn't we just give the function bytecode directly? Well, that's exactly what we can now do with Vercel functions. This is going to be rolling out to all customers in the coming weeks, and we're really excited to see these further improvements to cold starts. Now, what's better than running compute or having a cold start or no cold starts? If you don't have to run any compute at all. So let's talk about partial pre-rendering, which was a new experimental rendering model, which we introduced in Next.js 14. With PPR, you can optimize a significant portion of your page to be static. Then you can leave holes for the dynamic content defined by your React suspense boundary. So the static parts can get streamed to visitors instantly from the nearest Vercel region without blocking and waiting until the personalized components, like the cart, or my user profile, or that promotion that's going to allow me to get 40% off. So those are able to then stream in on demands. So this not only means that cold starts now are more rare and faster, but they also get to happen in parallel while you're running these static fetches and the dynamic content is streaming in. Now, we've been making improvements to PPR for many months now, and we're looking for your feedback as you experiment with it and try it out. To make this easier, you can now try out PPR on a single route versus opting in your entire application, and that change is included today with the Next.js 15 release candidate. Woo! Yeah, I'm pumped about this one. It's jam-packed with features. First up, we have support for the React 19 release candidate, just recently released. We have experimental support for the React compiler. Very, very exciting. I'm looking forward to using that in my own applications. Secondly here, something I've heard from many of you in the crowd, many of you online. Hi, Mom. Please improve caching in the Next.js app router. And I'm really excited to share that we've changed the defaults for caching things like fetch, and route handlers, and the client router cache, all these things, you know, you want to opt into that behavior. So starting with Next.js 15, we've heard your feedback and made those changes, which is great. Yeah, caching improvements. Woo! And as I mentioned, you can incrementally adopt partial pre-rendering. We also have a new design for Create Next app. Thank you, Evil Rabbit and Yaz. And it also now allows you to opt in to using TurboPack. So TurboPack just hit 100% of test passing for Next Dev, and we're really close. We're so close to marketing it as stable, so we really want you to try this out on your new applications, see how things work, and give us some feedback. All right, that's all for Next.js today. I'm gonna welcome Ty to talk about security.